What does that take for a guy that hasn't seen the playing time to get in there in these big situations to be able to run the team like you have?
Coaches always tell us 1 through 15, always stay ready. You know, we 1 through 15, we all always listen to him, stay engaged throughout the year.
And speaking of that, when you're out there, you're not looking to him. You're running the team. It's your team. How much practice have you put in to make sure that you know those plays like as well as you do?
No, I know. I try to learn all the plays 1 through 5 position-wise just because I know you never know where you'll be in transition or anything like that. And I feel like that's my role as a point guard, and that's good. Just really know everything that's going on.
Coming to Tennessee and being on the practice squad, and did you foresee being in this role at this point in your career?
My mother, she always says, I just keep the faith in God, and that's what I always do. So I can usually say that.
How comfortable did you feel like?
I felt real comfortable. You know, I'm not sure how many games that I haven't played, you know, in a stretch, but it really doesn't affect me. I'm just happy I can come out there and
when you saw Trey get hurt, that sort of keep you from coming back to play?
That's when I was that way, so it's really great. Prayers after Trey goes.
How hard is it to stay ready when you win a series of games without one?
It's really not hard at night, you know. Like Coach Martin always tells us, 1 through 15, stay engaged.
You said you're tough, you're from the East Side.
That's true.
Coach, talk about these games take a lot out of you as a coach, as a player.
Oh, yeah, I mean, definitely as a coach.
But these 2 1-point or a couple-point wins down to the last second, what does that do to you guys coming out of these games?
It gives us confidence knowing that we can close out games. Like, even though we did, we may have missed a few free throws. And plus, you know, the little guys were a little bad about that. So, you know, we all said, don't worry about it. We're going to stop defense because that's what we're going to focus on.
How did the other guys respond because you came here without a scholarship?
You know, we don't really know what each other's ball going on. So, guys, we're out of the family 1-15.
Well, you feel like you got their respect?
Yeah, definitely. Like, we all respect each other. You know, we pick on the freshman guys and stuff like that. But it's not out of fun because, you know, we all know.
It's uncertain about Golden's injury, but if he's out for a while, do you feel ready to pick up more minutes?
Yeah, I mean, it's whatever coach needs me to help out. That's what I'll do.
You talk about that last series when Johnson got the ball and your guard came to the box, he's going to go to the basket.
Yeah, but you know, I checked about the clock just to make sure that they wouldn't run another pick because we were switching 1-5. I think it was maybe 4 or 5 seconds left, so I could have not kind of just locked me in.
So is Eastern
Boston
really that tough?
I don't think so.
Well, I'm going to say, he's from St. Louis.
That's a lot different from that.
Brandon, were you expecting them to come at you?
Honestly, I didn't know. Like, you know, I got on number 11, and then when they did finally switch it up, you know, I did, you know, kids when they get the ball, it's like, here it is. I just really went there with the mentality. Like
did
that.
You ever play against him?
I've been playing kids from maybe since the spring of my 8th grade year is when I think I really saw him, and then freshman grade, it was like, he's real good now. Like, he really is. No, I think, no, sophomore year, we went to one of Andre's camp. He ranks like the top players in the state. It's like, he's real good. I've seen the pass.
What did you do to offset his size and strength on that last play?
Man, he just tried to slide and just jam up like my coach always teaches to do.
He said he felt contact and kind of tried to adjust and felt like that made him shoot too hard. Did you get into him a little bit there?
Yeah, but that's SEC basketball. So,
yeah.
Go ahead, sorry.
But yeah, like I said, you know, it's SEC basketball, so it's just, it's tough. It's tough on everybody defensively.
You said you'd played against him before. I can't imagine you were ever in a situation like that against him.
No, we weren't in a situation like that. We mainly just played against each other at camps and stuff like that.
So you probably weren't surprised at all how much success he had in the second half. It seemed like he was able to carve you guys up.
He's a really good player, you know. Like, I knew kind of, because he leads him in scoring, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Like, in the first half, you know, he was kind of out because of foul trouble. I knew the second half there, he was really going to pick it up and try to go to work.